Well, I think that when I came back from America after 7 years, then my first job was in Excel Rai, Jamshedpur. And from there, I went to Administrative Staff College of India, where I had the privilege of training the central ministers and the secretaries of Government of India. So from there, I moved to IIM Bangalore as senior professor and dean. And then from there, I joined MDI as director. And then I was persuaded by the Prime Minister to go to Lucknow, because IIM Lucknow was in trouble. So I think that after finishing my 5 years, I am Lucknow. Again, I was requested by MDI people to join back MDI. And then from MDI, I moved to IMI as Director General. And I think that I laid down my office around 3 years back. I am more involved in training the leaders at the top level. It's much more about the carpet boards and so on and so forth. And also going and lecturing in London, Paris, Berlin, I think that Thailand and Tokyo and those, so on and so forth. This national HRD, they are primarily in the business of grooming leaders. It's a tagline you will see, Center for Grooming Global Leaders. So it is not only the HR function, they are in the business of grooming leaders. Could be in finance, could be in marketing, could be in operations, could be in IT, all the fields actually. And National HRD has been very lucky to have many distinguished persons from the academia as well as from the industry. For example, Dr. Rajan Saxena is the very active member and also providing all kinds of guidance and support to National HRD network. And many persons like Santrupta Mishra, like, you know, Dwarikanath and Siddiqui. So if you talk about who is who, they are all associated with National HRD network because they feel that this is the one institution that's playing a very significant role in grooming leaders, which we require very much in this country. One thing which I find of late in the last 5-7 years, the government has realized that institutions in the private sector, they will play and they have been playing something very important role. And that's why government in all its judgment, you know, they decided that there should be 10 institutions from the private sector and 10 institutions from the public sector, which would be considered as the in the category of institutions of eminence, you know that. And I think that's one thing which I find. The second thing which I find, that government of late has realized by controlling or over-control, they are killing the initiative, they are killing the innovations, they are killing the passion to be entrepreneurial. I think that they said that why not we should try to provide them freedom. And I think freedom, whatever they want to do in their own interest and also in the interest of the country. And there is only one area where I have been always saying that those institutions which are in the private sector, not by the government, because those institutions which are in the government, they get free land, they get salary are paid by the professors, but in the private sector, they will have to earn the money to pay the salary, to build the infrastructure. So I think that we have been saying that, well, we must keep in our mind when we talk about the private sector. Number one, digital technology is a way of life. And if you try to see the way technology is developing, it's not only digital technology, there may be tremendous amount of robotization. And I always say that manpower requirement in the manufacturing sector, I think would be much less and much less. So this is the one area where management schools, even School of Technology, they will have to think, because future belongs to the service. For example, that we can think about health tourism, we can think about IT, we can think about banking, that these are the areas where I see tremendous amount of scope. But one thing more which I would like to say, we'll talk about digital technology or digitalization, but that would be a great aid, because the decision making, no doubt, many great decisions are by intuition. It comes from the heart. It comes from the mind. And I think mind is very different. It's not only cognitive self. It's also about spiritual self. It's also physical self. And I think that emotional self. So I think that technology can be used as a great help in deciding, moving further, and running faster. But it can't replace human beings. So that's why there should be, and very jokingly I say, that this robotization will take away the robotics parts from human being, and human beings should be focusing much more on non-robotic parts of the work and decision making. Number one, I would like to say one thing. One can't survive without other. इसको हिंदी में बोलते हैं राजस्थानी लैंग्वेज में चोली दामन का संबंध है. I would like to say that if we don't have a great academic institutions, who suffer? Industry. So that's why I think that if they are helping, they are working with the academic institutions, finally the gainer would be the industry people, not so much about the. Second thing that you find, the academicians will have to work with the industry, because that's where they bring pragmatism. And I think that's where the knowledge and action and thought and action, they combine together, because both are complementary to each other. Because without knowledge, without thought, I think the thought divide of action doesn't have any value. And action without knowledge is a futile exercise. That's why it's high time that industry academia should come together. And I think Rajan Saxena, person like Rajan Saxena, Chaturvedi, and Dhananjay, they have played a very significant role, that they have provided a forum where they can come and talk with each other and understand each other's problem. First of all, I must congratulate, because you are providing a very powerful forum for the academicians where they can articulate their views. And I always say, where the king doesn't listen to the language of Vaidya, doctor, he doesn't listen to the language of Mantri, and doesn't listen to the language of gurus, that society would be destroyed. So I'm very happy that you are providing a forum, because the gurus are known to say facts, you know that. So that's why government must also, so this forum can be great helpful to the government to find out how the intellectuals of this country, they think. Because you find, if America is a great nation today, it's because of the power of intellectuals. So is Germany, it's again power of intellectuals. So is Japan, it's power of intellectuals. So that's why where intellectuals are honored, respected, and appreciated, that society is going to be a great society. And thank you very much. And it was a great, exciting talking to you, because there should be such kind of activist. We also require activists who can pursue a vision and goal, and you are pursuing, and may God bless you.